Jai Ma. Namaste, everybody. Thank you for your patience, as always. It feels like, is it Mercury retrograde? Maybe it's just, I don't know what's going on. The technical mysteries have been abounding this week. So again, I thank you for your patience, as it took a little longer to get this configuration ready. But I think we are good now. So, okay. Let's do some chanting, yes? So we'll start with the Guru Pranam. And then we'll just see where Ma takes us. Anytime I try to plan these things, she just laughs. Namanala karam yaptam yena chara chara tatparam darshitam yena tasmai shri gurave namaha dhyanmula. Namah Shivaya. Thank you.
Shodehi, Ruisho, Jai.
Thank you. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Haribol, Haribol.
Everything in our lives is so perfectly orchestrated to get us home. And by home, I mean home to self, to source with embodied in us. You know, Ram Dass has that beautiful quote, "We're all just walking each other home, but where is home? It's not a final destination. It's our own hearts. It's the indwelling presence of God that has chosen to make herself at home as each of us. Not in us as a separate thing, but as us." And it's so incredible and completely mind-boggling if we really let ourselves think about that and think about what this Sanatan Dharma, what these teachings of yoga actually bring awareness of. We're these, to quote the Bible, we're these jars of clay. And these jars, hand sculpted by the Creator herself. And it's full of the most precious essence. Her indwelling presence, right? The Mahatmya says, "Know that you carry the mother always enshrined in your heart." Her, his, its, source, whatever you want to call it, this indwelling presence of love dwells in these jars of clay, these earthen vessels. And then as we meditate on the deity, on the form, on this idea of source or God, the more we meditate upon that form, the more we create communion and relationship with that form, the more the form fades into the background. And then we start to realize that there's no difference between us and that being. That indwelling love is us. That is our true nature. It's like if you have a lake or you have a pool, right? You have a pool full of water and you pour coffee into just the shallow end. It's just going to be in the shallow end. That coffee is going to spread throughout the entire, you won't be able to separate the coffee back up from the water. There's no separation. So it seems like the coffee, the jiva, is separate from the Atman, the soul, but the para Atman. But the truth is, there is no separation. That's the Maya. We just think that there is. And we behave as though there is. And all of our karmas from many, many lifetimes has all landed us in this opportunity where we have mandated time off to get to know this source, this self. And it's really easy, especially for those of us with trauma or who struggle with depression and anxiety, and I'm one of those people, so I hear you and I understand. It's so easy for us to get stuck in those really scary places during this time. And I was thinking about that today because I've been in a funk for days. And I just realized that many lifetimes of karmas have led me to this point in history where I get months at home. I was praying for a vacation, not quite like this, but you know, we'll take what we can get. Months of time to sit with this indwelling presence. Months, weeks, for some. For those of you who are on the front lines, you're not getting this time off, and we just appreciate and love you and thank you. But for the majority of us right now, we have a lot of extra time, which is kind of silly. Like, there's no extra time, there's just time. But we have this time that's available to us that we can fill up with things to do and distract ourselves and dissociate, or we can see that this is so precious. And that the grace of karma has led us to this place so that we can get to know self. pretty cool. Okay. I have an alarm on my phone that's going to go off on 9 that I at 9 that I forgot to turn off. So, we'll do one more chant for about 10 minutes. But really just giving ourselves that time to sit with that. There are no mistakes in our lives. There are no circumstantial coincidences. I mean, we dictate what's going to happen by our actions, right? But that's our karma. And there's a lot of grace involved in karma to get us where we need to go, where we need to be. And so somehow, somewhere along the many lines and lifetimes, we all got to be here together. So let's honor that consciousness and get to know this amazing love that we are. There's no separation.
Shiva Shambho.
we get to be here together practicing these mantras and asanas and meditations and pranayam, because there's an ancestry to yoga. And it's really important that we honor that ancestry, just as important as we honor our own ancestry, and we thank them for guiding us to this place, thanking the ancestors of yoga, the people of Bharata of India, who passed this down so graciously to us, who preserved it through so many circumstances that seemed impossible for it to have been preserved, and yet they guarded this treasure, and they chose to share this treasure with us. So honoring, so much honor to the gurus and the guides and the ancestors of yoga. Deepest gratitude. I knew she'd make an appearance at some point. Why are you wet? Okay, that's curious. This is Tallulah, and we're going to sign off now. We love you so much, and we're so grateful. We're so grateful to share this practice with all of you. Hari Om Tat Sat. Jaya Jagadambe Mataki. Jai Guru Dev. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Om Shanti. Have a wonderful evening, everybody. Next Thursday night, same time, we'll be here. We'll do some live kirtan and maybe some in between too. If you like the chants, you can check them out on my website, durgadasi.com. You can download. There are possible downloads, and you can stream them anytime. So please do enjoy and share. Okay. Jai Ma.